First things first, one thing that you guys have to understand is not everything that you own in your life, not everything that you own in your life is an asset. Hey everyone, Sanjay here from Contour Podcast. You are listening to Consan Show, episode number 215. And in this episode, we'll discuss about money. Yes, money has been one of our favorite topic for sure. And in this episode, we'll discuss about life money or lifestyle money. What does this mean? What is life money or lifestyle money? If you are just working in a 9-to-5 job, this video would be a basic money management video for you. And why further ado? We'll just start. Let's get started. Hey everyone, Sanjay here from Contour Podcast. You are listening to Consan Show. Never listen to any advice, guys. That's the advice that I want. These are nothing but you practice, 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 you become an expert one. Your network is your net worth. But I don't know how to start. Just start. Just people who are in 9-to-5 job. This video is for everyone who just earns money every particular month. If you are earning money every single month, or if you are an entrepreneur who is earning money and dividing it by 12, this video is for you. And if you could hit that red button, and if you could hit the notification button, daily motivation would be delivered to you. First things first, one thing that you guys have to understand is not everything that you own in your life, not everything that you own in your life is an asset. It's not 100% worth to buy everything that you have ever owned in your life. Think about this. The basic iPhone that you have, or the new iPhone that you have, what's the difference between that? Or the phone, the smartphone that you have. If you are just probably watching this video, I assume that you have a smartphone for sure. What is the difference between this phone and the new iPhone that you always wanted to buy? Do you need that for a necessity, or it's just a want to show off? Think about this. Buying a new iPhone and giving it to your crush just to take a selfie and just to post that on Instagram and worrying about hundreds of likes, that's not really worth spending 1 lakh rupees, right? That is what I feel like. Spend on what you really love. Spend on what is 100% worth. And what about this lifestyle money that I am talking about in this video? Lifestyle money is nothing but, let's say per month you just earn $10,000. $10,000, in the sense, I'll just make it very simple. Just consider it as $10,000 or 10,000 rupees. What is that 10,000 rupees doing in your life? How do you spend that $10,000 or 10,000 rupees in your entire month? Just try to analyze it. Not everything that you buy, not just by getting into Avengers movie on the first day, first show, does that sound really well when you are completely broke? For me, it doesn't sound really awesome. But let me break it down to you. Just assume this, 1/3 of your wealth, that is, if you are earning somewhere around 10,000 rupees or $10,000, think about this, 2/3 of your entire money, just 6,666, that's more than enough, that should be spent on your living money, that is your lifestyle money. That is nothing but your food, your mortgage, your rent, your fuel, your lifestyle. What does a lifestyle mean to you? Having junk food, anything. So that should be spent over there. And once your apple pie, that is your $10,000 of your salary, has been divided into 2/3 of your own income, you are now left out with 33% of your entire income. That is 66% you have spent it on your complete lifestyle money. That is called as your lifestyle money. And 33%, just divide that into three more different section. 11% of that entire salary, your salary or your monthly money, that should be spent over your happiness. It could be something like charity, or it could be something like traveling, movie, any entertainment that you always love to do every single month. It could be weekend party too. There are people who feel like, I am a boring person and I don't really party. No, it's not really that. Even I spend a lot on party, I spend a lot on movies. I'm a great fan of Marvel Studios and I watch hell lot of movies when it comes to entertainment section. But I don't consume lots of entertainment. When I consume it, I completely dedicate my time into it. So getting back to this video. So 11% you spend on your happiness, and the next 11% you just spend it on your investment. It could be stocks, it could be debentures, it could be something like your course, learning a new skill. That is always an investment. Spend it on your investment, the 11% that you have. And the next 11%, never try to spend that 11% every single month. Just try to save that. That money that you have, the 11% that you have, that will be a most important money for you when the pandemic hits in this situation. How am I really managing my entire company in this situation is with the money that I have saved. So savings is never a bad idea for sure. And why am I giving you this financial literacy or financial class in the sense? Because I run a company and that company is not bankrupt yet. So this is how I manage my money. And if you just follow this golden rule of lifestyle money, dividing it into 66, 11, 11, 11. So 11, 11, 11, three different parts. This money, you should never reduce it. If you could earn really more, then your lifestyle money could be reduced to 50%. Probably after 8 years or 10 years, what really happens is your lifestyle money would be reduced to 10%. And most of your money will be going to investment, entertainment, and savings. So that is how rich are getting richer and the poor are thinking that their lifestyle money is just being increased every single month. As they get a hike, they just spend more on entertainment, they just spend more on the food that they have or the mortgage or the credit card bill or the loans that they have. So never increase it. The lifestyle money should be the same. You can reduce it, but never try to increase that. This is the basic financial education that many people fail to understand. Congratulations that you have made through this video and you now understand this. You know, there are 80% of people in your family who have never understood this basic logic in their entire life, and that is how they are bad at money. But you being a person who always want to learn, you have understood this. Yeah. And if you could hit that red button, I would be very happy. And if you need daily motivation dose delivered, I'm delivering daily motivation dose every single day. And if you need that, make sure you just hit the bell notification next to it. And I'll be so happy, and that means a world to me. Comment below and I'll give a shout out for sure in my podcast. You could be the next one who'll be featuring in my podcast. Until then, it's me, Sanjay, signing off from Contrario Podcast. Meet you guys at my next podcast. Meet you at the top. Thank you. Bye bye.